In this lecture, we'll study about layout management in a GUI program. So let's first study what a layout manager is. Each container object that we create has a layout manager associated with it. Whenever a container is resized, or for the first time when you display the container, layout manager is the one that is used for positioning the components, placing the components within the container. We have a method in AWT called as setLayout that is used for deciding what layout manager the container will use. This is how the method is defined, does not return anything. And to this method, we pass the object of layout manager class. If we do not call setLayout within the container, then every container also has a default layout manager, and that would be used for positioning or placing the components within the container. There are many layout managers that are available in Java AWT. We will study three of them: flow layout, border layout, and grid layout. Let's look at flow layout. For the applet, flow layout is the default layout manager. This means that in the applet, if we do not say set layout, then the default layout manager that is used is flow layout. In flow layout, by default, the components are going to be placed left to right and then top to bottom. And between each component, there will be a small space of about 5 pixels that would be left, both above and below, as well as left and right. This is the constructor that we have, default constructor. The second constructor that you see here is where you can pass the alignment. So let's say all the components will be left aligned, or they can be right aligned, or they can be center aligned. Along with the alignment, we have the third constructor to which you can also pass the gaps or the spaces that you want to leave between the components. This is the horizontal spacing. This is the vertical spacing. So valid values for align parameter that you see here can be flow layout dot left, center, or right. These are defined as constants within the flow layout class. Let's look at a program where we use this. So here we have a class which is extending frame. That means the container that we are using is frame. For the frame, the default layout is border layout. That is why if you in a frame, if you want to use flow layout, then you must use set layout. And then create an object of flow layout class and pass that as a parameter to this set layout method. Within the constructor, you would also see other things like two buttons being created. Layout has been changed, and then the buttons are added to the frame. This would result in the buttons placed like this. By default, the alignment of the flow layout is center. So it will try to place it in the center. You see the first button that we have added is login. Besides that, the second button is added cancel. If you are adding more components, they'll be placed left to right. Okay, so after cancel, there'll be the third component and so on. When the space here is exhausted, then it will go in the next row and start placing the components in the next row. Thus, in flow layout, the components are placed left to right and then top to bottom. Here you see an example where we are changing the alignment. So the alignment by default is center. You can change the alignment by saying flow layout dot left or flow layout dot right. And you see how the two buttons that we added now are appearing on the left hand side of the frame. Next is border layout. Border layout has four narrow fixed width components at the edges and one large area in the center. This is how it appears. So at the corners, at the edges, you have four sections, four components: north, west, south, and east. And in the center, there is a large area which you can use. So in each of these sections, you can place the components. For the frame, the default layout is border layout. the constructor default. The second one is where you can specify the horizontal and vertical gaps, spaces between the components. And these are the constants. So because there are five sections in all in border layout, we have constants like center, south, east, west, and north. So let's see how we can use this border layout. We will be as a container using applet again. For default layout of applet is flow layout. So if with applet you want to use border layout, then you must be using set layout. So here in this program, we are using applet as a container. There are certain buttons declared here, one label. These buttons we will add at the four corners, and in the center, we intend to add the label. In init method, we instantiate all these components, all the four buttons and the label. For the label, the text that we want to display is center, and by default, label has left alignment. I wanted to display center in the center, that is why the alignment was changed to label.center. Once the components are created, we are ready to add them to the applet by first using set layout. So we say set layout. To that, we create an object of border layout, pass it as a parameter, and then you call add. Here, when you call add for border layout, along with adding a component, you must also specify in which section of the border layout you want to add it. So the first button has been added to the north section. This is how you see the button here. And now you can see how the rest of the buttons are added to each of the four sections. And then the label is added at the center. The next layout that we have in line is grid layout. Grid layout creates a two-dimensional table or a grid, and the components are added in that. Constructor default. Then you can call a constructor and create a grid with the number of rows and the number of columns that you wish to have. Along with the number of rows and the columns, you can also specify the spacing between the components, horizontal and vertical. Let's look at this program here, where we are using as a container an applet. And in applet, we will create a grid layout for creating such an applet. So here you would see there is one label, then there is one text field, next label, another text field, and two buttons. So if you look at the structure of this applet, then you will see that there are three rows in all. One row where we have a label and a text field, second row where we have a label and a text field, and third row in which we have two buttons. So there are three rows in all, and there are two columns. So in the first column, you will see two labels and one button. In the second column, you will see two text fields and a button. So for creating such a container or such a layout, we will have to use grid layout, which is having three rows and two columns. So let's see how that is done. Of course, we need various other components. So here there are two text fields, one label and two buttons. This label is not actually required, so you can ignore this. So we just need two text fields and two buttons. Labels we will add directly to the applet, which you will see in the program later. So in the init method, instantiate, create these text fields, create the two buttons. After doing that, set the layout of the applet to use grid layout. As I told you, we need three rows and two columns, and then start adding the components. So when you add the components in grid layout, you don't specify in which column which row. That is not required. It will start adding from the first row, first column. Okay. So when here I'm adding a label, which is username colon. So this will be added to first row, first column. That is what you see here. Next thing that we are adding is the text field username. This text field will go in the first row, second column. So first row, second column, it will go. Now first row is over because in the first row, I can have only two columns. So the third thing that I add, new label email, this label will go in the next row in the first column. And similarly, this will go in the second column of the second row. And then finally, we have two buttons which will go in the third row in the two columns that we have created.